Hey everybody, Michael here from Avesi. With spring 2022 in full swing, I've had the opportunity to see a bunch of unique landscapes, and right now I'm doing a design for a downtown Hamilton home. Now, because in this area the homes and the properties are so tight together, we don't really have the luxury of a lot of room to put the water. So we're going to have to be really calculated on where we put it and how we get it there. The solution that I've come up with has a catch basin draining to a rain garden, and on top of that, we're going to be redoing some eavestroughs and downspouts in the area. Now, this particular homeowner has not only water ponding on the landscape in the backyard, but they've got water getting into the basement. So it's going to be really important that we get this solved for them. The reason I want to share this with you is because I'm hoping it can give you some insights onto how to deal with your own space if you're a homeowner, or how to deal with some customers' spaces if you're a contractor. So if you've got any questions about what I did or why I did it, feel free to ask and we can generate a dialogue that way. So with that being said, let's get into the video. All right, so here's a simple sketch of what the backyard looks like. I want to point out to you the three different camera positions that I'm going to be showing you photos from. The first one is the view as soon as you enter the backyard. The second one is going to be looking back at the gate that we entered from. And then the third one is going to be from the deck looking back into the backyard. And here's what you see as soon as you enter the backyard. You can see it's a really tight space with the big tree in the back, the ivy and the pathway and the deck further into the backyard there. Now the next photo is going to be looking at the gate. You can see the eavestroughs straining back into the rain barrel. This is the main thing that we're going to have to solve. And then the third photo is from the deck looking into the backyard, right where that bird feeder hanger is. That's where the catch basin is going to go, and it's going to lead water under the pathway into the backyard. Now, here again is the original view that we're looking at, and you can see right where the patio stone walkway label is, there's a little bit of a dashed line that has arrows going one way and the other. That shows the general grade of the landscape. So, this property, because it's so old, isn't really set up to have proper drainage in any way. It's really just however the landscape is falling, that's where things are going. So what we're going to do is lean into this and get all of the water as far back into the backyard as we can. So here we have the concept sketch that I've come up with. You can see the main difference is instead of there being a rain barrel near the gate, there's now a catch basin near the deck. So this catch basin is going to be taking all the waters from the newly directed eavestroughs and downspouts, and then it's going to take that water in a pipe under the flagstone walkway and then into a rain garden at the back of the property that has a vertical T pop-up style atrium grade emitter, as I've done in a bunch of my projects, and I have a video about it on my Instagram page if you want to check that out. And then beyond this landscape, the backyard is actually at a railway right of way, so there's no rear neighbors, so we can direct the water into the backyard and it will just roll down the hill into the green space there that's adjacent to the railway tracks. So here are the three photos again. Now that you've got a little bit more information, you can start to picture how these different elements are necessary and how they will fit into the landscape once this is all buttoned up. Of course, these downspouts are going to move to further into the backyard, right at about where that bird feeder stand is. So that's it. That's the plan that I came up with. If you've got any questions about what I did or even how I did it, feel free to ask. If you've got any questions about your situation or you want to see videos about a specific drainage component or layout, let me know because I'm sure I've seen it before. Now, to me, the most important part of this project that I just described is redoing the eavestroughs and downspouts because that's where all the water originates from. So instead of having the downspouts drain to that low corner by the rain barrel and the gate where the water can't really go anywhere from there, to me it makes sense to invest the money, redirect the eavestroughs further into the backyard so that they can then go into the catch basin, the rain garden, and then into the railway right of way beyond that. Now, our objective with the rain garden is to use the landscape to absorb some amount of water. But then, if the system is full and it's still raining, then we use the land beyond the property that we can then safely drain the water to. So, again, if you got any questions, let me know. But that's all I had for this video. Thanks for stopping by.